Now come to see an example based on the concept discussed earlier about Riemann integration. See, show that a constant function small k is integrable and integration from a to b small k dx is equal to k into b minus a. See here, our function fx is your small k, which is constant, and the limit of integration is a to b. So we have a closed interval ab and we need to make its partition p. See, for any partition p of this interval, we know that lower sum lpf will be written as small k delta x1 plus small k delta x2 plus 1 plus small k delta xn. Why? Because in each delta xi, the smallest value small mi will be small k, since the function is constant. So mi, m1, m2, m3, m4, and so on, mn, all of them are equal to small k. So take small k common. So within bracket, we have delta x1 plus delta x2 plus 1 plus delta xn. So this is equal to k into b minus a. Why? Because this delta x1 is x1 minus x0 plus delta x2 is x2 minus x1 plus 1 plus delta xn is xn minus xn minus 1. So you will have only minus x0 plus xn, and minus x0, x0 is your a and xn is your b. So this is your b minus a. It means LPF is your small k into b minus a. Therefore, lower integral small a integration from a to b k dx is equal to supremum of LPF. Means take all the values of LPF and take their supremum. So since it is a constant, so supremum will also be k into b minus a. Similarly, evaluate upper integral from a to b k dx is equal to infimum of UPF, and it is written as infimum of k delta x1 plus k delta x2 plus 1 plus k delta xn, because in each interval delta xi, the maximum value of fx is small k, because fx is a constant function small k. So this can be written as k into b minus a, as we have seen earlier in our LPF. So see here, both of them are equal. Therefore, integration, lower integration from a to b k dx is equal to upper integration from a to b k dx. It is equal to k into b minus a. So both integrals equal. It means that the function is small k is integrable. So first part is proved, small k is integrable. And also integration from a to b k dx is your k into b minus a. This second part is also proved. This is a very important example for you to understand what this Riemann integration is. See another example, a very good one, and it was asked several times in your examinations. Show that the function f defined by fx is equal to 0 when x is rational and fx is equal to 1 when x is irrational is not integrable on any interval. Before proceeding, keep this in your mind that in any interval, closed interval AB, if you partition this into n sub intervals, so for the sub interval delta xi, there are plenty of rational numbers and plenty of irrational numbers. So fx will be 0 for plenty of times and fx will be 1 for plenty of times, because fx is defined as 0 when x is rational and fx is defined as 1 when x is irrational. So consider a partition p of this interval ab, then UPF can be written as summation I is equal to 1 to n capital MI delta xi. This capital MI is the maximum value of fx in a sub interval, and see here, from the definition of the function, maximum value of fx is 1. So this one will be in each subinterval. So this will be 1 into delta x1 plus 1 into delta x2 plus 1 plus 1 into delta xn. So its value will be b minus a. Similarly, Therefore, upper integral from a to b f dx is equal to npimum of UPF, and it is your b minus a. Since UPF is constant, so infimum of UPF will also be a constant, b minus a. Similarly, the lower integral from a to b f dx is equal to supremum over LPF. It means supremum over 0 into delta x1 plus 0 into delta x2 plus 1 plus 0 into delta xn. It is equal to 0. Why this 0? Because in each subinterval delta xi, the minimum value of the function will be 0. Since fx is defined as 0 when x is rational and 1 when x is irrational. So the function fx takes only two values, either 0 or 1, and the minimum of them is 0. So this 0 comes here. It means its supremum is 0. So see here, this b minus a is not equal to 0. Therefore, upper integral f dx is not equal to lower integral f dx. And therefore, this function f is not integrable. There is one more example for you, for your practice. See, show that x square is integrable on an interval 0 to a, closed interval. We can partition this interval 0 to k into n equal parts. The points are 0, k by n, 2k by n, and so on, ik by n, and so on, nk by n. And I minus 1 k by n whole square, I into k by n whole square. These are the lower and upper bounds of the function. Why? Because the function is fx equal to x square. And in any subinterval delta xi, the delta xi means xi minus 1 xi. And the minimum value will be I minus of the function fx is equal to x square is I minus 1 into k by n whole square. And the maximum value will be I into k by n whole square. So these two are lower bounds and upper bounds of the function in delta xi. See here, the length of each subinterval will be k by n. Since 0 to k is divided into n parts, so each length is equal to k by n. Now, UPX square is written as capital MI delta XI, summation over I is given to as capital MI delta XI, and each MI is your I into K by N whole square. So K by N whole square comes out to be common, and K by N is your delta XI, so it is K cube by N cube, and within bracket I square, summation over I is given to N I square, so it is 1 square plus 2 square plus 1 plus N square. It means k cube by n cube into, substitute this value, it is n into n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 by 6. Now divide by n cube, so it is k cube by 6, 1 plus 1 by n into 2 plus 1 by n. This is your up x square. Similarly, lp x square will be k cube by n cube, 0 plus 1 square plus 2 square plus 1 plus n minus 1 whole square. So it is k cube by 6 into 1 minus 1 by n into 2 minus 1 by n. See, infimum of UPX square. See, this is our UPX square. For infimum, for its minimum value, 1 by n should be 0. So 1 by n will be 0 only when this n tends to infinity. So in that case, infimum of UPX square will be k cube by 6 into 1 into 2. So it is k cube by 3. Similarly, supremum of this LPX square will be k cube by 6. Into 1 into 2, so it is k cube by 3. So both of them are equal. Hence, the given function x square is integrable, and integration from 0 to k x square dx will be your k cube by 3. There is an example for your practice. Show that 3x plus 1 is integrable on closed interval 1 to, and integration from 1 to 2, 3x plus 1 dx is equal to 11 by 2. This you practice at your home. Next, see here, inequalities, we have some inequalities for integral, and before this, see here an example. A function f is bounded on closed interval AB. Show that first, when k is a positive constant, upper integral from a to b k f dx is equal to k into upper integral from a to b f dx. and lower integral from a to b k f dx equal to k into lower integral from a to b f dx, since a is a k is a positive constant. But when k is a negative constant, then upper integral from a to b k f dx will be k into integration lower integral from a to b f dx, and lower integral from a to b k f dx will be k into upper integral from a to b f dx. See, if f, the function f is bounded and integrable over this closed interval a b, then the function k into f, this function k into f will also be bounded and integrable over this closed interval a b, where k is any constant. And integration from a to b k f dx will be k into integration from a to b f dx. There is a hint given. If you cannot solve the problem, you ask me, I will do it for you. If capital M I and small m I, these are bounds of f in delta x I, then k to capital M I into, and k into small m I, they are bounds of k f in delta x I, if k is positive. But in case k is negative, the bounds of k f will be k into small m I and k to capital M I. So in case k is positive, the situation is different. But in case k is negative, the situation will be different. So for in each case, you will have this result. So next time, in my next class, we will proceed further for inequalities, inequalities for integrals. Till then, it is over from my side. If you have any query or any difficulty, ask me your questions here.